This is my collection of car radios, and I need to downsize it because most of these have not been used in years and they're just taking up space, so I figured other people could get more use out of them. Most of these have AM stereo, but some do not. I'll point out the features of each one as I go along. I could list them all on eBay, but it takes up too much time to take all the photos and write all the descriptions and all that stuff, so I figured I'd just do a video here and offer it to my YouTube audience. Some of these will be giveaways, some of them will be for sale. This first one here I did a video on a while ago. It's branded as a Technics, but it was actually made for Toyota cars. But it's a standard doubled in size, so you could put it in any car that accepts that size. It's a Toyota model number 5627. This one does have AM stereo. Now this one has some problems though. The FM only gets static. The AM works fine, as well as the cassette. But after about 10 or 15 minutes, the amplifier shuts down. The radio keeps working. You can still see the display. You can still tune in stations. But the amplifier goes into protection mode. So it must have some kind of problem with the output ICs. So it will need some work, but the cassette player works fine and the AM tuner works fine. I did get the wiring harness for this, so that will be included. And it does have the color codes here for all the different connections. So this will be very easy to hook up either in a car or even just on a workbench. You just hook it up to a 12 volt power supply or a 12 volt gel cell battery and some speakers, and your antenna plugs right in here. It's a standard Motorola connector, and the trick is you can just stick in a nail in the center pin of that and just connect a clip lead to that, and that's your antenna. So if you're just using it on a workbench, you don't even need the special connector. You can just stick in a nail in that hole there and it'll work fine. So this one will be a giveaway. Just pay for shipping and it's yours. Now this one I'm keeping. This is the Spark-O-Matic SR430. I had this in my 92 Jetta many years ago, and I love the way it looked. This all lights up orange. Even the display is orange LEDs. Very unique look, and it has this neat 5-band graphic equalizer, and it's a very wide band tuner on AM. So I'm keeping this one. But behind it we have more radios, of course. This one came in my 97 Passat when I bought it back in 2005, and I think it was a fairly new radio back then, so it must be from around 2004 or so. It's a JVC KDG210. And it's fairly modern. It can play CDRWs. It works perfectly. The CD player, the radio, everything works fine. I do have the holder for the faceplate, and I printed out the manual. I didn't get the manual with it, but I went to JVC's website and I printed out the manual. And the good thing is, even though it's not AM stereo, the AM tuner on these JVCs is wideband, so it sounds nice and crisp on AM. This one I'm asking $20. Plus shipping, because it's a new style radio. I mean, you can go into Best Buy and get something like this for $100, but this one I'll let it go for $20, and it works just fine. And yep, it does include the wiring harness too, so that's all ready to be installed in a car. Next is a Clarion Audia 200E. This is a top-of-the-line radio for its time. It does not have a built-in amplifier. It's only preamp outputs. I do have the manual for it here. This does have AM stereo, as well as Dolby B and C noise reduction on the cassette. You can see right there, AM stereo, Magitune. And they give you bandwidth selection for the AM stereo. You can get your equalization for metal and chrome tapes, Dolby B and C and noise reduction. So this was a very good radio for its time. This one, I don't think I ever tested the cassette, but the radio works perfectly fine on both AM and FM. There's the wiring diagram. So, it does not have a built-in amplifier, but but you get preamp outputs. So it's easy to hook up on a workbench to an amplifier. Just plug in RCA jacks. And this one, even though it's a top-of-the-line radio, I don't have any use for it, so it'll be a giveaway. Just pay for shipping. And it does come with a cover. It's not a removable faceplate, but it does have a cover. So you just pop that on and people don't even know it's there. Below that is a Mitsubishi Diamond Audio DX4. Another top of the line radio. I believe this one was also no built-in amplifier. It's only preamp outputs. This one also works fine. Has AM stereo, as it says right there. Again, Dolby B and C noise reduction. I believe this model was sold both on the aftermarket and by Mitsubishi dealers to be installed in new cars. And this is one of the oldest radios you'll see with a CD input on the front panel, which of course you could use for an iPod or an iPhone or anything else. So that's really nice. And that's another giveaway. And below that, a Nissan Bose head unit from the mid-90s. You see right there, AM stereo button with dynamic noise reduction. It is a standard DIN size, but I discovered that it's not easy to install in a different brand of car besides Nissan because it has a diversity antenna connection. In fact, I have another Nissan radio here. And this is the same model, same AM stereo button. This one comes with mounting brackets. And you can see, instead of the normal one pin, it has two pins for the diversity antenna. So if somebody has a Nissan car from probably the late 80s through maybe even the late 90s. I don't have the wiring harnesses for these, but if you have a Nissan and you want to put AM stereo radio in it, you're welcome to either of these or both. As far as I know, they both work fine. Now this one I'm keeping. It's a Sony multi-system AM stereo car radio XRA740 in the box, so that one I'm keeping. But below it is a Sherwood CRD350. It was their top-of-the-line car radio with AM stereo. As it says right there on the cassette door, it even says C-Quam, AM C-Quam stereo. Now this one works, but I think one of the display segments on the LCD is getting intermittent, so it'll need to have the solder joint retouched on that. I did have this installed in my 89 VW Golf, but when I sold that car, I took it out. So that's another giveaway. Now this is a GM Delco radio from around 1993. Cassette player, AM stereo, automatic dynamic noise reduction. So this was the UX1 model and it works fine. And I'm asking $20 for this because these are very popular radios for anybody that has a GM or just even just putting on your workbench. It makes a great radio because these are very sensitive on AM. So this one will be $20 plus shipping. Here's a generic AM only radio from the 60s. Solid state. It works fine. I just don't have any use for it. So that'll be another freebie. And free mounting frame with any car radio. I have plenty of those. This one I'm keeping. It's the Chrysler Infinity Gold CD player AM stereo radio from a 1995 Jeep Grand Cherokee. Very nice radio, very good sounding, and I'm keeping that. So if you want it, too bad. But if you're looking for a Chrysler radio, I have something else here of a 1988 Dodge Dakota. This was their base model radio with AM stereo. Some of the buttons are worn off, but everything works fine. And it's even pre-wired to use on a workbench. You get your 12 volt input here, and your left and right speaker outputs here, and the antenna jack, and you're good to go. Works fine. So that's another freebie. Now this is a VW radio with AM stereo. No extra charge for cobwebs. It was a very rare radio, only used in 1985 and early 1986 models. It's unusual that it's just a radio, no cassette, but it does have AM stereo and dynamic noise reduction. And get your volume knob, and the ring here is the tuning. So if anybody wants it, you can have it for free, just pay for shipping. Now this is from a Mercedes-Benz from the mid to late 1980s. You see right there, well, that's their way of saying it has both AM and FM stereo. It says AM-FM-stereo. And it's a Becker Grand Prix. And the nice thing is you can directly type in the frequency. I think you hit the star and then you just type in, like, if you want 98.3, you just type in 983 and it goes to that frequency. It was made in Germany, and I do have the original booklet for it. They even show it receiving an AM stereo station on the little pictogram there. So if you have an older Mercedes, a very nice radio to put in. It's the factory original radio that Mercedes used. It's model number 754. So if anybody wants it, you can have it. Just pay for shipping. Here's another GM Delco radio. This is a rare model. This was, I believe, the first radio they ever offered with AM stereo in 1984. It's only a radio, no cassette, but you can see it has an AM stereo switch right here, and this one works perfectly. And this is another radio that I pre-wired to use on a workbench. You get your speaker outputs and a 12 volt input. So if anyone wants that, just let me know. This one is a Pioneer KEA433AM with AM stereo and FM stereo. You get your bandwidth button and your stereo button right here. This one works fine. This frame around here is not original to the radio, so the things it says over here don't apply to it. But the radio itself works fine. So if you want a shaft style radio for AM stereo, this one fits the bill. And I do have, let me see, I do have the original owner's manual for it. It has a Super Tuner 3. So anybody wants that, let me know. Now these two do not have AM stereo, but if anybody wants them, just let me know. Otherwise, probably be donated to the thrift store or something, because they work fine as far as I know, but I just don't have any use for them. So you have a nice Saturn radio. It's like a UX1, but I don't think it has AM stereo, although it does have automatic DNR. And this is a Chrysler radio, one of their more typical models. It's an RAS with the tape player, but I don't think this one has AM stereo either. Now this, believe it or not, is a car radio. It's a gooseneck mount head unit. Blaupunkt Dallas SQM88 with AM stereo and dynamic noise reduction and ARI, which was the predecessor to RDS. Comes with a separate tuner box and amplifier. Says 4 times 20 watts. The head unit plugs in there, you get your antenna and some kind of jacks there. I don't know what the purpose is. There's your speaker outputs and your power input. There it mentions the ARI and the DNR. And I have the original manual for it. Stock mount AM/FM MPX radio with separate remote tuner. And if we open it up, AM stereo C-Quam with wideband selection. So this one I'm asking $40 for, just because of its rarity. There were some high-end European cars in the 80s which came with one of these. I think the CX Auto, which was the American version of the Citroen, came with these radios. So it was a very high-end radio for its time, and very hard to find. another Blaupunkt, but a much newer one up here. It's the Orlando CM127 from around, I'm gonna say around 1997 or 98. It does not have AM stereo, but Blaupunkt advertised it as having superior AM frequency response. I have a video about this if you want to hear for yourself how it sounds. And it's working perfectly fine. And it's a fairly modern radio, so I'm going to ask $10 for this. It'll look great in a 1990s car. It almost looks like a factory radio because it has nice clean styling. But it's a very nice 90s car radio. And here's a Volkswagen radio I got for $4.99 at the thrift store. It's, I'm going to say early 2000s, late 90s. Cassette. No AM stereo, of course. But it's the Premium 4 model made by Clarion. And I believe that is the code written right there. So these are security coded radios, but this one has it written right on there. So that's no problem. Yeah, it's actually 1998. At least that's what I think that stands for. So if you have a Volkswagen and you need a factory radio for it, you're welcome to this. This will be a freebie. Here's another one I'm keeping. It's a Marantz 701. Probably the highest end aftermarket car radio with AM stereo ever sold. It is security coded. I do not have the code for it, but I think I can call Marantz and see if they can get me the code for it. It has DBX noise reduction on the cassette, as well as AM and FM stereo. And the last one of these that was on eBay sold for, I think, $200. So needless to say, I'm keeping this one. And there's the Visteon CD6. I'm keeping this one. I have two videos on it if you want to see what it's all about and how it works. Very nice factory car radio with 6-disc CD changer, DSP-based AM stereo. It's one of the few car radios that receives C-Quam AM stereo using digital signal processing instead of an actual C-Quam decoder chip. And it also has RDS on FM. And finally, another Blaupunkt. This is the Tucson SQR06 with AM stereo, wideband AM, Dolby B and C noise reduction, as well as dynamic noise reduction. You get a separate button for that. And this does not have a built-in amplifier, but I do have the separate amplifier for it. 4x20W RMS. Comes with the power wiring, but you will need to get a DIN extension cable, because obviously, unless you can mount this right next to the radio, this little thing won't reach. I do have the original manual for it. Again, it mentions AM stereo C-Quam with wideband selection, dynamic noise reduction. This one also has ARI. You can see the button right there. So another high-end European car radio from the 80s. I believe these were installed in Porsches. So if you were rich enough to buy a Porsche in the 1980s, it probably would come with one of these. And I'm gonna ask $20 for it just because of its rarity. And it's another very high-end car radio from the 1980s. This one works fine. And that is including the amplifier, of course.